Welcome to the Dirttime channel. I'm Alan Halcon.
I'm Dude McLean.
And I'm Christopher Nyargesh.
We're going to do something a little different today. Today, Christopher's going to take us on a...
I'm taking you guys?
Yeah. Well, yeah, you're the plant expert.
Well, we're all going together. I'm not really taking you guys anywhere.
Oh, no, we're jumping on your back.
Okay. Here's what's happening. He's leading us down the garden path.
There we go. Let's go.
Not so much of a garden path, but okay. All right, well, cool. Look what we found, some mullein here. What can you tell us, Christopher?
Well, the mullein is really soft, like flannel. And when you first find mullein, you want to smell it, make sure it's not mullein leaf nightshade, which is actually toxic.
Right.
It's not very common. But this is an incredibly useful plant. You can use it as a pot holder, use it as toilet paper. I use it in my herbal tobacco smoking mix. I just let it dry and I blend it with other herbs. Yeah, it feels good, doesn't it?
I like it as a tea.
Makes a good tea. It's good for breathing problems. And you know, remember the slush lamp that you made?
Yes.
This is an old, you dry
this
these
leaves.
This is
an leaves, old wick.
Old fashioned style right. wick.
Wow, very cool.
Yeah. And then the second year, this grows a stalk, correct?
That's right. And then Halcon, what do you do with that dried stalk?
Whatever I want. Beat you over the head if I wanted to.
You probably would, but in your case, you take the dried mullein stalk and you make
a
fire.
Well.
Or some guys do.
Guys who are skilled at this.
The problem with Alan is it's always specifically about Alan.
Right.
Other people would use it as a hand drill, Alan. You got that?
I'm not concerned about those other people and their hand drills.
But we're trying to
convey some information. Overly concerned about criticism from other people. You don't need to be overly concerned about criticism. You have beat the world record and you've made a fire in 12 seconds. 2 seconds.
I'm out of here.
Wait a minute. You've heard go pound sand?
Okay.
So this is a nice looking thistle you found here, dude.
Yeah.
It's very prickly. It hasn't flowered yet. And the thorny leaf indicates its relationship to artichoke. Right, Alan?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, but some people talk about eating the root. Some roots, if it's in really good soil, can be eaten. But what Dude is doing here in a masterful and very careful way is he's taking the leaves off of this plant that has not quite flowered yet. If it's already flowered, the stem gets very woody. But he's taking the leaves off of this tender stem, and then we're going to sample it for our repast. For our repast. Do you know, when his birthday comes up, buy him a dictionary.
I will. Yeah. I have Google. I don't need a dictionary.
Okay,
you're just as outdated as those damn encyclopedias that are no longer being sold.
Is that true? Okay, so anyway...
Well, the information isn't outdated.
No, it's just that when the power goes down, your little Google thing that you carry in your pocket will do you no good.
I have a permanent dictionary in there.
See how deftly he severed the stem? And you don't have the pith in the middle. And he has a little bit of hair.
I got a little bit of hair. You don't want those on there.
Yeah, I'm taking a little hairy part.
Take those off.
It's crunchy like celery. And this is actually a good patch. Thank you for finding this, Alan.
It was Dude that found this. I just set up the camera.
Good in salads, good in soups. It's actually really tasty. You could put cheese on it, salt on it, whatever, you know, peanut butter on it.
Hey, how about some of that dressing people criticize you for?
It's in my car. We could put dressing
on it. What? Now you don't have it on you?
I don't have it with me at this moment. All right.
This is also good for quenching your thirst.
Yeah, this is very good.
You'll have another.
Well, wait a minute. I don't want to give you an inferior piece again.
Right.
Again?
Again. The first one had a little fuzzy.
I expect all of my thistle stems to be thoroughly cleaned before they're handed to me.
This is really good, man. Good find on this one, dude. Let's go see what else we can forage.
I see some radish over there.
Cool. Let's go take a look.
Let's go take a look at that.
Nice spot on this, Christopher.
Yeah, some wild radish. And this is a European native, but it's found all over North America. Typically, you've got the lavender type flower, but they're sometimes white like this, even sometimes a little yellow.
You think that's because it's more in the shade here?
I'm not really sure if it's shade or soil conditions or whatever, but it's a very typical mustard family member with the four petals.
Yep. No, I was going to say, why don't you tell us about the four petals?
Well, there it has four petals.
Four petals, four sepals, six stamen, four long and two short.
That was good.
He was good.
That was good. Yeah.
And it also has these little pods.
That's right, very typical
of the
mustard
family.
And
they taste just like a radish.
Well, I was going to say they are in the mustard family.
Well, that's because they are the mustard family.
Yeah, but you tried to do that to me last time and you were right.
I was right?
Yeah, I accept your apology.
Thank you. I'm not sure what just happened, but the little buds are good. Hey, they're spicy. The tender leaves are good. They're spicy. Interestingly, the only thing you can't eat on... God, this is hot.
Yeah, it's really
hot. You guys
hot.
Are weak.
We are?
Yeah.
We're not used to eating raw jalapenos.
Then hold us up.
No, this is hot. This is very hot.
What do you mean it's hot? It's not hot.
The one I had. My mouth is burning.
The one I just had was. The first one was not hot.
This is good and
the second one.
This is all
really
subjective. You guys are crazy.
Of course it's
this
subjective.
Is not hot.
No,
wait a minute. What
hot.
Isn't subjective?
The fact that this isn't hot, that's
what
my objective opinion.
Subjective? All right, we found this.
This is used in raw foods, raw salads sparingly because it is so hot. And objectively, this is hot. Okay? And the one.
I object to that.
I know that. That's why I said it. The one thing that you do not eat for the most part on the wild radish is the root, which is what we think of as a radish, because the root is very fibrous. Sometimes there's a thin outer flesh that you eat. But the flowers, the buds, the pods, and you could pickle those pods too, like little capers.
Yeah, no, these are
really
good.
Tasty.
Oh, incidentally, if it was a caper, all the stamen would be the same size.
Alan has been schooled by the best, and he's doing his homework, and he's learning.
And
well.
I still don't know anything you've taught me.
Well, I just, whatever. Jude has some saying like that, but I forgot what
he
it
is. He has a good memory, but it's short.
Yeah. Yep.
Well, okay, so we move along?
Yeah, let's find something else. Well, cool. Some Yerba Santa here, Christopher.
Yerba Santa.
Wait a minute.
Yerba Santa. Spanish? Our
it's
Spanish
Saint
linguist?
Weed.
Okay, technically that's how you might translate it. Yerba is herb,
yeah.
Weed, and herb. Santa means saint.
I like weed.
Or holy. It's,
well, no, not that type of weed.
It's generally.
Oh, you know what I mean.
I'm not sure that I do. It's generally translated as holy herb, and the name was given to it by the Spanish missionaries who used it as a veterinary herb on horses, but also on external wounds of people. And what do you guys use it for?
Well, it makes a good tea if you have a sore throat.
Sore throat, coughs, things like that.
Yeah, it works really well for that. I think there's probably several other uses.
Well, you know, I actually dry this along with five or six other herbs, and I put it in my dried herbal smoking mix.
Yeah, I mean, the one way to really... that really stands out with this, it's really sticky,
and there is this is a chaparral zone, and people in the eastern United States are not going to see this is strictly in the desert regions, and you get into higher elevations and there's the very sticky one, which I actually prefer, but you have that very distinctive Yerba Santa aroma, and it makes a pleasant
very
smoke.
Pungent
it's semi-pungent
when it's very pungent. Very hot, it really really smell it.
Yeah.
Right. And it gets much taller than this.
Oh, flowers. Absolutely. I've seen this plant huge.
Yeah.
Well,
very
cool.
Good.
Let's go see what else we can find.
All right.
You can stay here.
Okay.
Help! That's disgusting.
This is good. What are you talking about?
It's good chickweed.
I'm not a cow.
This is good.
Or a horse.
You look like one.
Yeah, I know, but...
You guys know how to recognize chickweed, obviously, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, but look out for the...
Also... You have the line of fine hairs right along the stem.
The dog just peed on these.
Probably, but it's good.
Opposite leaves, little white flower with five petals. Very good in salads. That's why I carry the salad dressing. Chickweed is everywhere.
There you go.
What did Martha Stewart say about this stuff?
Martha Stewart one time said, and by the way, I want you to know, unlike you, Alan, I don't watch it regularly. I was painting the ceiling and I couldn't get off the ladder.
So you were stuck on the
hook. I was watching something previous to Martha Stewart. Or listening anyway.
Were you using a pad or a roller?
Just like you suggest, a pad. Okay. And she said, get rid of that chickweed right away because it takes over your petunias and pull it out. And there's even poisons you can buy to spray on your lawn to kill the chickweed because it grows on lawns.
I hate when something takes over my petunias.
This is delicious. I've actually come into places like this when the chickweed's dying, collect it and scatter it in the yard so the seeds will come up in my yard.
Where's your salad? If you had your salad dressing, I could pour it right here, right now, and just start grazing.
It's good to occasionally experience salad au naturel.
You know what? Since you won't graze, you want me to feed you?
Uh-huh.
It's considered a natural diuretic.
It's high in
calcium, C, and a lot of things. Good in salads. Jim Robertson likes it in stews and things, but...
No, it's really good.
It's good in a lot of different ways.
Well, cool. Let's go find some more food.
Okay.
Hey, Christopher, thanks for taking us on that exciting walk.
El gusto fue mío. Was that correct?
We don't care.
Anyway, thanks for watching dirttime.com.
Check your six.
Was that good Spanish, by the way?
No. It might have been good.
Was that right? El gusto fue mío? El gusto es mío. El gusto fue mío.
All those people all across the Midwest is going to have no idea what the hell you're saying.
And we're still rolling on this, so this is good banter for after the fact.
No, but isn't that the correct
Spanish? No, yes, you were.
See?